Hey Scott, come over here and take a look at this.
What is it?
The sensor seems to have detected a trace amount of exotic matter in this hair sample.
What? Let me see.
Yeah, it's detected a kind of complex mass in the atom's hair, which could be a sign of Tachyons. A hypothetical particle that could somehow travel faster than the speed of light. Which could then be a cause of interdimensional travel. Exactly. This pony having traces of these particles on him not only proves that he is indeed from another dimension, but that such a dimension exists, linked via a quantum field. So, can we extract these particles and build something to help us explore the universe better?
Well, no, not exactly. These tachyons can't be collected or contained, and since they travel faster than light, we can't even examine them properly.
Somehow, we need the pony to help us if we want to harness that potential power.
Bill! Bill!
Jeb, what is it?
I took ads to go see the big black stone thing outside the space center, and when we were looking at it, these red numbers appeared!
Numbers? So they just appeared when you arrived?
Yeah, I think me being here triggered something in the monolith.
Yes, we discovered some exotic matter in your hair sample that definitely indicates a possibility of interdimensional travel. As Kerbals, it's always been our mission in life to explore the Kerbal system and learn as much as we can about the universe through scientific experimentation. But the possibility of discovering other universes could lead to countless scientific breakthroughs.
Oh man, imagine if we could actually go to another universe, discover all kinds of life, be able to build bigger and more powerful rockets. That'd be the adventure of a lifetime.
Well, if you guys can use that to help me get back home, then I can definitely help you get to alternate universes.
Alright. Ads. It's a deal.
Great. Now, about that monolith, those numbers look like coordinates to me.
Yeah, I quickly wrote them down here.
Really? We should head back to the tracking station and take a look at the Kerbsat map. Alright, so that monolith, did you call it? Showed a set of coordinates, which I should be able to find using the orbital satellite relays we have around Kerbin. So, 66 degrees, 3 minutes south, 160 degrees, 53 minutes west, puts us right here.
But Bill, that's just in the middle of the ocean.
I know. We've already mapped every square meter of Kerbin and there's nothing out there. So, I thought maybe the top number, 44.36 degrees, could be like an angle to travel away from the space center, but then that makes the coordinates useless. Well, what else could it mean?
Hang on, what if 44 degrees was like how Kerbin was angled relative to another planet?
What? You mean the planetary phase angle? That could be it. So if Kerbin is placed at 0 degrees in relation to the Sun, then what planet is at 44 degrees?
Huh? Duna!
Can you show us an orbital view of that planet too?
Of course, let me access our Duna satellite. Well, the coordinates point to around here, in a region unexplored by Kerbal Nauts. Just these coordinates isn't a lot to go on, but they only appeared on the monolith when you arrived, so they must be important. It's a bit of a long shot, but if we're gonna get you home, I'm betting we need to get to Duna and see what's at the polar ice cap.
Well, it's not like I have any other choice.
Alright, I'll notify the engineers that we need to plan a mission to Duna. Alright, Scott. While you do that, I'll talk to the other scientists to plot our course. Duna's already in almost the perfect position, so we should want to get ready as soon as possible. Jeb, can you show Ads to the Kerbal Complex?
Sure. I also train him what it takes for space flights, you know, so he's ready for it.
Alright, you do that. Ads, good luck.
Thanks.
Alright, let's get to the hangar!
Jeb, wait up!
Well, this should be interesting.
Alright, Ads. So before you can go to space, I need to run some scientific tests to see if you can withstand the high G-forces.
Right. And you're gonna use this?
Yep, it's a centrifuge, which will spin you around really fast, creating G-forces.
Yeah, I've seen these things before.
Alright, well, hop in and I'll start it up. Ready?
I guess so.
Alright, here we go!
Oh.
1G. 2Gs. 3Gs! Jeb, what are you doing? Oh, hey Scott. I can add in the centrifuge. He's holding up really well. Jeb, add this in a Kerbal. He can't take 10 Gs of force. Shut it down. I think we should try some more scientific tests. Alright. Come on, Ads.
I'm coming.
Lift off. Good, now go get that.
Yes!
It's ready. Well, there it is. I guess we should head to bed now. It's gonna be a big day tomorrow.
Yeah, I guess so.
You alright, Ads?
I'm just nervous about it. This is a lot different to what I'm used to.
Well, don't worry. We've been to space dozens of times. We know what we're doing.
Yeah, thanks.
Hey man, don't worry. Everything will be fine. We'll fly up into orbit, dock with the mothership, travel to Juno, and we'll get you home.
Thanks. I appreciate this.
Don't worry about it. Now come on, I'll show you to your room.